Hello, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to the Practical Pain Management. I'm going to share cervical extrafibrinal perineural steroid injection practice. Intervertebral foramen consists of internal and external intervertebral bony foramen. These drawings show the relationship between bony foramen and nerve root. The nerve root sits on the floor and is covered with the sidebars. External intervertebral consists of fibrosarcoid tunnel. The floor is an intertubercular sulcus formed by anterior tubercle, posterior tubercle, and intertubercular lamella. The roof is free space. Blue color indicates the intertubercular lamella. Each cervical vertebra has a different shape of transverse process. C1 and C2 have a single blunt tip of transverse process. C3 and 4 have small rudimentary anterior tubercle. C5 has a smaller size of anterior and posterior tubercle. C6 has the tallest anterior protrusion of the anterior tubercle. C7 has a single big blunted transverse process. It has a rudimentary or no anterior tubercle. Can you tell the difference between these cervical vertebrae? Please guess the level. Now the answer. Number 1 is C5. Number 2 is C4. Number 3 is C3. Number 4 is C7. Number 5 is C6. One more time. Number 1 is C5. Number 2 is C7. Number 3 is C6. With the characteristic anatomy of the cervical vertebra, it is easy to identify the exact level. At C7, there is no anterior tubercle and linear transverse cortical echo. The vertebral artery and veins are located in the medial aspect of C7 nerve root. Several hypoechoic C7 neural fascicles are found emerging from the flat transverse process. At C6, there is a prominent and tall anterior tubercle and V-shaped relationship in anterior and posterior tubercle. We can find and trace the C6 root between anterior and posterior tubercle. At C5, the anterior tubercle becomes smaller and lower. There is a small U-shaped relationship between the anterior and posterior tubercle. C5 nerve root emerges from the base. Let me introduce my patient. He is 67 years old and admitted for his right scapular and arm pain. He also complains of upper extremity weakness. He showed a positive swelling sign and weakness on his triceps muscle. His simple x-ray shows diffuse cervical spondylosis. Sagittal T2 weighted image shows reversed cervical curvature and bulging disc. Far lateral sagittal image shows black disc protrusion at C5-6 and C7. Oblique sagittal T2-8 image shows black disc protrusion and foraminal stenosis at C5-6 and C6-6 level. Axial and far lateral sagittal T2-8 image shows degenerated black disc protrusion at right C5-6, C6-7, paracentral protrusion. What I put in each level, I put 0.5 ml of 2% of mefivacaine, 1 ml of 30% of dextrose solution, and 1 ml of dexamethasone palmitate. I always put 1 ml of iohexol contrast media at one point. Before pre-scanning, I put some liquefied gel for skin lubrication. I use mixture of chlorhexidine cream, 80% of alcohol, and chlorhexidine solution. Before the injection procedure, I need to full search out all the anatomy. I need to find several nerves and vascular structures. This scan is a transverse scan at the area of cystic root. Anterior tubercle of cystic is not clear because of anisotropy. It is not difficult to find a linear transverse echogenic posterior tubercle. Single or several hypoechoic neural vesicles of the cystic root can be found in the groove. If my needle approach close to the neural vesicle, I need to move very slowly. Frequently, I used dehydrodissection technique to separate the tissue and fascias. This scan is a transverse scan at the area of C7 root. The transverse process looks linear echogenic line and it has no anterior tubercle. I can find the C7 nerve root medially. If my needle approach close to the neural vesicle, I need to move very slowly. Frequently, I used dehydrodissection technique to separate the tissue and fascias. I need to confirm and verify my procedure with the contrast media. I use 1 ml of iohexol. One of two targets, I infiltrate contrast media only one level. This is C7. Nerve root can be recognized as a filling defect. Thank you for your attention.